This video will explore the basics of the selection mode. You can get to the selection tools from the operation mode pull-down menu. Or you can use Command 6 on the Mac or Control 6 on Windows. When you switch to the selection mode, the mask will automatically be checked. However, when you select a different operation mode, the mask will be unchecked, so you will need to check it before adding any effects to your selection. There is a lasso, rectangle, and ellipse option. The ellipse option has a slider that changes the shape of the ellipse. Full on gives you a circle. Most of the selections have a soft or hard option, but you can also choose to feather or invert through the canvas selection menu. As you can see, there are a lot of selection options here that are addressed in other videos. I'm going to remove this selection by choosing Canvas, Selection, and then set to Full Off. There is also a circle paint option so you can draw in your selections. You can choose how large the brush is by using the radius slider. By holding down the T key, you can move the selection. By holding down the M key, you can copy and move a selection. You can use the texture option to select the texture parts of an image and then apply an effect. Let me show you an example. I'll select the texture of this image, then I'll toggle to the vectorizer. Here is what this effect looks like without the texture selection. And this is what it looks like with it, which is a very different effect. I'm going back to the selection mode by using Command 6 on the Mac. If you are using Windows, you should use Control 6. These two options, Canvas and Source, are interactive selection options which either use the Source or Canvas. Generally, you will probably want to use the Canvas, but there are times you would want to use Source. For instance, if your Source image was different from your Canvas image. Both of these options, as well as Source Texture, have these same choices. Local grows the color from wherever the selection was initiated. Global selects the color everywhere based on the color where you first mouse down. Global color is like global, but it's not based on position, but rather whatever color you first choose. Local path is like local, but more like the magic wand in Photoshop. If you want multiple selections, just hold down the Shift key. If you want to erase a selection, Option Shift on Mac, or Alt Shift on Windows, and use the lasso or circle paint to remove the selection. If you forget any of these hotkeys, you can find them at the bottom left-hand area of the interface when you mouse over the canvas. You can also find them in the Help menu, by choosing Index, and then choosing the Hotkey Guide. The last two options I want to show you is the Frame Partition and the Partition. The frame partition will simply make a picture frame. Partitions make rectangular partitions of the whole canvas. If you drag the mouse sideways, it makes a vertical partition selection, and if you drag it up or down, you will get a horizontal selection. And just like all the other selection types, you can use the hotkeys to move, rotate, and copy your partition selections. And that's the basics of the selection mode in Studio Artist.